I start with presenting two projects. The projects are for migrants and youngsters from the block. I will tell you what it's about. Let's start with the migrants. I mean, what we have done at the museum is to design a project for financial inclusion and financial education for migrants. And the idea is to help them to be socially integrated. As you know, migrants may even be more in need of financial education because they have a very special need to manage their money, both to live a decent life, they did a long trip to come to our country to have a better future, but also because they want to have some money to send back to their families. And then, I mean, financial education is also very powerful as a tool because it provides multi-purpose skills that are useful for dealing with money, but also for dealing with life and daily life. What we have done, we have studied the literature and studied the experience of other countries and other organizations that have started to work with migrants. And all these experiences were summarized, suggesting that a participative, interactive methodology is very useful for migrants. I mean, it's more effective. The direct approach, the personal relationship is very important, much more than distant learning. So what we have done is we designed a workshop and interactive activity to make in a way that they will be involved in this financial education program. We have a two-layer structure, so basically what we do, we have an entry level that is a test to understand what is their level of knowledge on the topic, and then we offer two different modules. One that is, we call it basic module, that addresses mainly saving, planning and budgeting, and one that is more advanced and is a little bit more complex because it addresses topics such as the relation between risk, return, diversification, financial instruments and so on and so forth. Each model is very interactive, so it's not the kind of frontal teaching approach, but we have a discussion, an open discussion about habits, about culture, because we discovered that in some countries, in Africa, for example, the idea of saving is completely unknown for various reasons. So we have really to find a way to address the issue specifically to each ethnic group. And then we have also practice. Some practice is also very useful because they do it individually and as a group. The University of Turin is always evaluating our workshop, whatever we are doing, and what we do, they prepare specific surveys before for the entry level and after to see if something has changed whenever they've been treated. We have also a control group, and actually we are trying in principle to have a checkup after 6 months. It's not easy because these people may be no longer in Italy, so tracking them after 6 months may be difficult, but this is what we want to do because behavior don't change in 4 hours, okay? Behavior change over a longer time. So the start date has been November last year. We are still ongoing. Until summer, we treated more than 300 migrants. Most of them were at the basic level, so they got the basic module, but some of them come back for the advanced module. The preliminary result from the University of Turin that is monitoring our activity is that the treatment improves migrant knowledge of financial education, and actually what come out very clearly, they are very happy to be part of the project, not only because of a sense of inclusion, but also because they think they need to know more about how to manage money in a country that they don't know, and the culture is very different. What is the issue to solve? We found, maybe surprisingly, some problem with the association that are hosting the migrants. They were very skeptical about the fact that we can address this kind of issues to people that has no money. I try to convince them that financial education is extremely powerful, properly for people that has no money because there's a budget constraint, and since they come to us, they cross the sea to come in Italy, probably they are willing to make money and that they will have money in the future, and they need to know how to use it. But what I figured it out is that probably their problem, I'm talking about the Italian manager of the association, is that they don't know. They don't have a knowledge of financial literacy, and they're afraid that maybe the migrants can ask them questions that they will not be able to answer. So what we are doing, probably in the next future, is to do some financial education program also with the managers of the association, because otherwise it will be very difficult to get the right number. We are aiming at 500 people by the end of the year, but 500 people have been very difficult to have it in our premises. It was really a difficult job. The other project that I want to present to you is something that is in theory. It's a project for youngsters from the block. I used a very famous song, but I wanted to mention the students that are attending borderline schools in very bad neighbors of big cities. And this project is done for kids that have really a very bad and very round down social and economic context. We found that most of these kids, because they come also sometimes to the museum, are squeezed in the short-term horizon. So they are not allowed to think to the future. And that this is a cultural problem, but also an environmental problem. So we want to push them to think about their future, because we think that it's very in need, that they understand that the suburbs are not an insurmountable limit. I mean, they can go beyond the barrier, they go beyond the border, and this is exactly what we want to do. We want to let them peer out of the window so they can understand that there is another world and they can be part also of other context. What we are doing is to organize an educational project that will let them to imagine their future, okay? So you can think this is not a financial education, but this is part of the financial education because it's human capital. And human capital, as everybody knows here, is the first investment that we are asked to do at a very young age. So this is what we are doing here, okay? So we are supported by the Global Thinking Foundation that gives us some money, some support, and also we are working, as I said, to two main topics: planning and entrepreneurship. So these are the two topics in which we were working, and we will engage a teacher. What we want to do is to push youngsters to think in the long term, and also to behave as being entrepreneur of themselves. So to understand what is behind an entrepreneurial behavior, and as I said, the idea is to push them to invest in their human capital and to stay in school, because it's very likely that living in that kind of suburbs, they will be leaving school before the end. Okay, the project is starting now. So the participants will be, for the year, 600 students from the middle school. We select the school with the regional educational office. There is a training format that is also devoted to training the teacher, because teacher will be our ambassador. So they will be, you know, the one that will talk to the student and will, somehow provide the information. We will work with the teacher constructing this module, and then they will come to the museum. They will have laboratory activities. We have several things that they can do, and there will be an evaluation. This time, I decided to get rid of the survey, to get rid of all these questionnaires that are useless, according to my experience. People is providing answer to the questionnaire in a very lousy way. I mean, especially if they are a long questionnaire, there is no way that these questionnaires are filled in a proper way. Okay, so questions that are missing, and so on and so forth. So we are trying to do something completely different. We are involving psychologists and teachers, because we are asking to perform somehow, to do some work before and after the treatment, let's say. So the student will be asked before and after the workshop to paint, write a song, record a video on how they picture themselves in 10 years, how they see themselves in the future. And they will do it twice, at the beginning and after this 2 months of work. What we want to do with the psychologist and the teacher is to understand if something is changing. I finish my time, so. Just in time.